Yeah, I was talking about the total admission outlook and opportunities a student can look forward during this period of crisis. And we have to see post COVID-19 that everybody is trying to predict that probably by September or something, that the by June or end of September things should become normal so that we can start normal life. But WHO says that we need to live with it just like other virus factors. So just let me cover a few scenarios right now in the study abroad market. Universities have suspended physical classes because of the travel restrictions and other reasons where there is because of pandemic spreading. But from the day one, all universities have taken care to see that classes are not missed, classes are not disturbed. They have been running online classes, and several other private portals and other education forums also running several classes so that students are not disturbed with their normal classes. Universities are running the universities with skeletal staff, with the security and the minimal admin staff, to see that students with any queries or concerns are not put into inconvenience so that work goes smoothly and students are not inconvenienced. And there are plenty of support provided by the embassies, by the universities, by private organizations for students to make sure that they stay safe, they are well informed from every agency so that they are not put into inconvenience. And in terms of mobility, some of the countries have allowed and let students move out of their country in case they want to travel to their home countries, without disturbing their visa or study permits. They have been given exemptions and time holidays so that they don't lose their visa permits when they come back after this pandemic problem. They have been given from 2 months to 3 months to 6 months, which they can be extending as long as they don't feel safe to come back or to travel. And along with that, there are plenty of travel restrictions that are in place. Preventive measures have been put in place. Along with this, this is the peak time where admissions and applications are happening. So, I have not backed out of applications and admissions are happening as planned. But because most of the staff are working from home, it is about, the admissions are a little slow, but it's been happening. We have been getting scholarships which are being offered. The university themselves predict that, things can come down, or the pandemic crisis can come down by July end or June end, so that things will return to normal and students start coming to universities. Now, with these preventive measures in place, there is a lot of things that universities and other funding organizations or other people have helped students, like fundings, like, people have been helped, students have been helped with funding in terms of living expenses and fees to be paid. Several funding organizations and universities have brought up several funding options for students in the university, and some of the international students also have taken use of it. And there being a lot of waivers being offered by universities so that they admissions can happen smoothly, GRE waiver, GMAT waivers, entrance exams waivers, and all these things. And several organizations and bodies which are running English tests have brought out alternate English tests which have been recommended, like, do it from home. The home editions have come in from TOEFL, IELTS, GRE, GMAT, and a lot of these things. A few universities have said that till this next time when they decide, they have also stopped the requirement of accepting SAT and GRE and GMAT and all these things. So plenty of flexibility given to students so that their admissions are not hampered, and students are also allowed to travel in these conditions with travel restrictions. And once these situations come to a normal and getting into normalcy, right now a few universities have already opened in some parts of Europe where they've started classes both face to face in some parts with restrictions, and online classes also being happening. And US, Australia, New Zealand and UK are planning to open their borders, but with restrictions that students coming in or people coming in will not re-trigger the pandemic, so that they have been given 14 days of quarantine facilities so that the country also is safe and the students coming in are also safe. So these kind of restrictions and travel models are planned with the countries. And Canada especially has brought out 2 weeks back that they have relaxed entry visa permits by giving students a chance to study, stay in their home countries, take their classes, and then probably when the things relax, they can come in and continue with their studies, or they can still study in their home country and still enjoy the post-study work permits. Those kind of facilities are being extended by the countries, and universities. Now, a few concerns that might come to us will be in this time as because of the long delays in admissions and the embassies not yet open, there might be a small window period for visas to be given, and that's a concern. I agree, but all the embassies and universities are putting in place contingency plans to face these shortfalls to make things smoother by extending entry intake dates, by making visas process faster, accepting alternate English tests, and all these things are being planned by several embassies and universities to facilitate that students are not put into a lot of inconvenience. Yes, rules have to be followed by the concerned embassies, but they're also trying to be more flexible in terms of being very facilitative.